The vote for the next Speaker of the House is expected to take several hours and multiple rounds, as some Republican members remain steadfastly opposed to GOP leader Kevin McCarthy's nomination.
So we may have a battle on the floor, but the battle is for the conference and the country, and that's fine with me.
A block of the more right-wing Freedom Caucus members have pledged not to vote for McCarthy.
This has gotten down to where it's personal, I think, for some of these members.
McCarthy has struck deals to win over some supporters, and he met with holdouts Monday night in an attempt to win them over as well. But Congressman Scott Perry tweeted that McCarthy wouldn't accept their demands.
We said, we can get you to 218 with this. He stood up and he shook our hands and he said, I can't do it, or I won't do it.
The deals McCarthy has struck in his bid to become Speaker of the House may make it harder for him to do the job. One of the concessions is an agreement to make it easier to remove him as Speaker of the House if his party members don't like the job he's doing.
You essentially cut yourself off at your knees on being the Speaker, that you don't have the authority and the ability and the power that that goes with the office if you give all that stuff away as part of a negotiation.
With the new Congress comes some new faces in new roles, including Democratic leader Hakeem Jeffries of Brooklyn becoming the first African-American to lead a major party in Congress. And embattled Long Island Republican George Santos is taking his seat even as he's under scrutiny after admitting much of the biography he presented to voters is false. Nicole D'Antonio, CBS News, Capitol Hill.